Hello guys and welcome to SSIS 101. In this video you will learn how to get data from SOAP web service in SSIS. It will also be helpful if you just want to read from XML files or use any other XML based API. If you don't know already, SOAP web service is a special type of website which is supposed to be used by programs instead of humans. As the name suggests, it is an HTTP-based service provided by some company or a person your application can use to get or send data using XML. Actually, like computer programs, it supports complex data types and has methods which you can call to get or send data objects. What data types and methods you can use are defined in SOAP web service WSDL. So, what is a WSDL? WSDL or Web Service Description Language is an XML file which reveals how web service works. Basically, it contains service location, a URL you have to make HTTP requests to, data types, and the methods you can call. WSDL is usually exposed by a service provider and can be downloaded. Let's begin and see how to make calls to SOAP web service in SSIS. In this part, I will show how to call a SOAP web service method, get the data, and then save the results into a database. So suppose you have this publicly available holiday service to SOAP web service, which lets you get the holidays for specific countries. So we can proceed to WSDL part. So we can access it using this link. So as I told before, here is all the types, data types that this web service supports, listed under element types. Then you have methods with the tag operation. And then you have this link below which you will need to use to make the requests to. Basically, it's service URL. Okay, so we need now to save the WSDL, and then I will use this SOAP UI, a popular SOAP and REST-based web services testing tool. You can download it using the link in the description of this video. So to proceed, we will need to create a SOAP project. And find the WSDL we saved and load it. Okay. So you have all the methods that this web service supports. We will be using get countries available. I mean, we will be calling it. Let's expand it and double click on this request one item. And what SOAP UI did for us is generated this SOAP request. And basically that's all we need to do to get the response. As you see, SOAP envelope, SOAP request is made of two parts. Basically it's header and body. In header you usually you pass authentication details, and in SOAP element you pass all the information that is needed for the request. In this case, it just get countries available method name. Okay, so if you need to authenticate, press this tab, auth, then select add new authorization. There are several types here. You can use any of them, I mean whatever that is supported by your SOAP web service. So in this case we will be using basic. Let's click OK, and then we can enter the username and password. So to authenticate, select this authenticate preemptively. Okay, so another authentication mode you may use is WSS, and to use that you just need to add this authorization, basic authorization, and then right click on this window and press add WSS username token, and then select either password text or password digest, whichever your SOAP web service supports. So let's click password digest, click OK, and as you see, security element was added within header with our username, and the password was entered in digested mode. Okay, so I will remove now this header because we don't need it, and also I will select no authorization. So now we are ready to make a request. Let's make a request, and here is the response from the web service. As you see, SOAP response structure is similar to the request. You have envelope element, and within you have body, and within that body you have response element, and in that response there is all the data we need. So in our case, it's all the countries that this web service supports: Canada, Great Britain, and so on. Okay, so now we are ready to move to Visual Studio and create a package. So let's first create integration services project, and then find data flow task and drag it into control flow, click edit, and then find XML source component, drag it into data flow, click edit to edit it, and now we are ready to fill in all this information. Okay, so you can either enter URL here manually or using connection manager. So in this case, I will show you how to use connection manager to show how authentication should be made. Okay, so we will need web URL. Let's go back to SOAP UI. Yeah, we can go here in raw tab, select and copy, and paste in here. Then you can enter authentication mode. There are several options here. So basic, the one you saw in SOAP UI I just used, and there is also this SOAP WSS with password text and password digest. So when you use WSS, our component will automatically include that security element within header tag, and username and password will be included in SOAP request. Okay, so I will use now basic just to show you how this works. John Doe, even this service I use doesn't require any authentication. Let's click OK. Okay, the next thing is we have to set request method, content type, and add several headers. So let's go in SOAP UI again. So basically you have just copy paste what you see here to XML source. Let's go back. This it was post. Let's go back again, select SOAP action and content type. And we just appended here at the end. I could have used this body content type option and select this, but just using raw edit made it faster. Okay, and the last thing we have to set body itself. Let's go back to XML tab, copy and paste it here. Let's say you may want to use a variable if you want to make your request dynamic. Let's say you have a SOAP request and you want to get the holidays for a specific country. I mean, this is not the actual request, but I mean, if there was a method with that kind of parameter, you could parameterize country and include it as a variable. So it would look like you would just need to press insert variable and select the country variable. So it would look like this. Okay, I will remove it, press OK. And we are now ready to make a preview. Okay, the preview doesn't show the information we need. Basically, it's XML in one row, and we need to get the list of countries, right? So I'm closing and using this filter to select data from XML response. I'm selecting envelope. Remember, then you have body, then the response, and then within that we have country code element, which includes all the countries. Yes, we want to use it to treat it as an array. Okay, and let's make a preview. And we have Canada, Great Britain, and other countries here. Click close. I will limit the response to 3 countries just to show you that it's possible. Then let's move to columns. So as you see, XML was parsed into columns, code and description, and sometimes you may want to use the lock option. You want to do that when you, let's say you change the data type for some columns, and I will change for 2 columns. I will change the data type and the length 100 and 100, and I am locking here one column. So now when I refresh the columns, or in other words when I update the metadata, only this column will be updated because it's not locked, and this will stay intact. So let's watch. Okay, and as you see, description was reverted back to wide string, and the length was changed from 100 to 46. So this might be really useful. Okay, so now we are ready to run the package. I'm closing. One more thing. I need to add OLADB destination to save the data, obviously. Creating new connection and creating new table. I will name it country. Click OK. Mappings. Click OK. I will add a data viewer here so that you could see what data is being passed from XML source to OLADB destination. So we are now almost ready to run the package, but before that I will show you that the table is empty, as you see, and now we will fill it with data. I'm executing. Data viewer popped up, and you see Canada, Great Britain and Ireland Northern. I am closing it. Opening SSMS again. Refreshing. And as you see, all the countries are present in the table. That's it. We successfully called SOAP Web Service and saved the data into a database.